If you like this video, don't forget to smash the like button. Subscribe and stay informed. Addicted to Macintosh.
macOS Ventura. Locks by default hidden and recently deleted albums in the Photos app in previous versions of macOS. The hidden album in your photo library can easily be made visible via menu bar option in the Photos app. While any recently deleted photos are available for anyone to peruse while your Mac is unlocked. In Ventura, however, the hidden and recently deleted albums in the Photos app are locked by default and can only be unlocked using your login password or Touch ID. It's that simple. How to delete duplicate pictures and photos on macOS Ventura. Apple has added a new duplicates album as a sidebar item in the Photos app, which will automatically detect any duplicates in your library and collate them together for your inspection. Bear in mind that the album only appears if you have duplicate images on your library. Inside the duplicates album, you'll see duplicates listed in chronological order, with a merge button beside each set. You can tap this button to merge duplicate sets into an individual photo, even if you take two photos together that are very similar. Apple's merging feature will intelligently keep the highest detail and the most metadata, creating the best possible image. It's that simple. I will show you how to add Stage Manager icon to menu bar. If you like to be selective in your use of the new Stage Manager app window management feature in Ventura, you can enable a menu bar item that gives you quick access to an on and off toggle. To do this, go to System Settings. At System Settings, go to Control Center. At Control Center, find the Stage Manager entry, and then select Show in Menu Bar in the drop-down menu beside it. It's that simple. I will show you how to set multi-window support in Stage Manager. In early beta versions of macOS Ventura, Stage Manager would only let you view a single app window, even if multiple windows from the same app were open. In the final version, however, you can opt to display two or more windows from the one app overlapping or side by side. To do this, go to System Settings. At System Settings, go to Desktop and Dock. At Desk and Dock, switch on the toggle for Stage Manager. If it's not already active, then click Customize. Finally, click the drop-down menu next to show windows from an application and select all at once. It's that simple.
I will show you how to use nearby iPhone as microphone input on a Mac with macOS Ventura. Ventura allows you to use your iPhone's camera with continuity camera feature, and it also allows you to use your iPhone's microphone as a microphone input. To enable it, go to System Settings. At System Settings, go to Sound. At Sound, click on Input tab under Output and Input, and you should be able to see and select the name of your iPhone provided that you are on the same Wi-Fi network. Bluetooth is on both devices, and both devices are logged on to the same Apple user ID. It's that simple. I will show you how to add time zone clocks to New Clock app on macOS Ventura. Finally, the clock app on iPad and iPhone is now available on the Mac. It shows the current time when placed in the dock. Adding time zones is very easy. Just go to the plus sign on the top right corner and type the name of the area you want to add on time zone. It also includes not only time zone options but also alarm, stopwatch, and timer, all accessible via four tabs in the clock app interface. How to quickly convert images in Finder on macOS Ventura. There are many third-party apps available for Mac that will convert images for you, but if you're running macOS Monterey or later, You can convert an image or a selection of images from directly within Finder using a quick action. If you're not familiar with them, quick actions help you perform certain tasks, such as creating a PDF or rotating an image, right from the Finder or your desktop. Without opening an app, the Convert Image Quick Action can quickly convert an image file from one format to another. It also lets you batch convert selections, change the file size, and choose whether to keep the file's metadata in the converted image. To use the Convert Image Quick Action, select an image file or drag a selection box over several files, then Ctrl-click and select Quick Actions. Next, select Convert Image. In the dialog that appears, choose the desired format, JPEG, PNG, or HEIF, and the output file size, small, medium, large, or actual. Check the box to preserve the original image's metadata in the output image, then click Convert to Format. The converted image will be saved in the same folder as the original image, which will remain intact.
I will show you how to get terminal full access on macOS Ventura. macOS Ventura comes with extra security. If you are having trouble getting terminal full disk access on macOS Ventura, here is how to fix it. First, click on Apple icon in the top left of your menu bar and choose System Settings. At System Settings, click on Privacy and Security. Now at Privacy and Security, click on the Full Disk Access tab. At the Full Access tab, click on the terminal toggle to the on position. Exit System Settings. It's that simple. Hope you enjoy this video. Have a nice day. I will show you how to set iPad as a second external display. To set an iPad as a second external display on macOS Ventura, here is how to do it. First, make sure that both Mac and iPad are on the same network. Next, make sure that both devices have their Bluetooth on. Next, place the iPad close to the Mac. Now go to System Settings. Next, at System Settings, go to Displays. At Displays, on the right side, there is a plus button, click on it and choose the iPad. It's that simple. Hope you enjoy this video. Have a nice day. Subscribe and stay informed. Addicted to Macintosh. More than 1,200 Apple product-related videos. Thank you for viewing, subscribing, sharing, and liking.